The hat's the clip.
Woo! Welcome to the Forever Sevens virtual open mic. All right, let's get it. Woo, woo.
Thou hadst the clearance too, and Richard killed him. Forth from the kennel of thy womb hath crept a hellhound that doth hunt us all to death, that dog that had his teeth before his eyes to worry lambs and lap their gentle blood, that foul defacer of God's handiwork, that excellent grand tyrant of the earth that reigns in galled eyes of weeping souls, thy womb let loose to chase us to our graves. O upright, just, and true disposing God, how do I thank thee that this carnal cur preys on the issue of his mother's body and makes her pew fellow with others moan? To which Richard's mother says, no, by the holy rood, thou knowest it well, thou camest on earth to make my earth my hell. A grievous burden was thy birth to me, tetchy and wayward was thy infancy, thy school days frightful, desperate, wild, and furious, thy prime of manhood daring, bold, and venturous, thy age confirmed, proud, subdued, bloody, treacherous, more mild yet more harmful in kind and hatred, what conformable hour canst thou name that ever graced me in thy company? And then Richard says, I do the wrong and first begin to brawl, set secret, the secret mischief that I set a broach, I lay unto the grievous charge of others. Clarence, whom I indeed have laid in darkness, I do beweep to many simple gulls, namely to Hastings, Derby, Buckingham, and say it is the queen and her allies that stir the king against the duke, my brother. Now they believe it, and withal wet me to be revenged on Rivers, Vaughan, Gray. But I sigh, and with a piece of scripture, tell them that God bids us do good for evil. And thus I clothe my naked villainy with odd old ends stolen forth of holy writ, and seem a saint when most I play the devil. But saw, here come my executioner. So wrote William Shakespeare.
Wow.
Thank you.
And so he wrote. Okay. Up next, we have David.
Hi, Word.
Hey, John.
Hey, Word.
Hey, man. How you doing, girl? It's good to see you. I missed last week.
Oh my goodness. You know, you attend here so much, like your energy is just, it's just floating all around our platform. So it carried over.
That's good. Yeah.
You were here in spirit. Okay.
So I can do poetry. Tell me the rules, please.
The rules are you can do poetry.
okay.
You can do poetry, improv, comedy, whatever you like to do. Music. We have some musicians that join us.
Well, I can tell you my favorite joke or read you a poem I wrote. Pick.
Okay.
A bit of improv.
I'll go for a joke.
All right. I'm fishing the other night out the lake when the guy next to me says, buddy, I got two great cigars here, but no way to light them. Can you help me out? I said, you know what? I think I can. So I rifled through my tackle box and I found a lighter that's almost as long as across my screen here. That big. And it worked. So I'm enjoying this cigar when he says, I've never seen a lighter like that. Where'd it come from? The pal, you just won't believe me anyway. So, well, try me. I said, okay. The genie in my tackle box gave it to me. And he said, yeah, you're right. That's a stretch. I said, well, rub the tackle box. And if he comes out, maybe you get something too. And he looks at me. I said, yeah, you got nothing to lose, pal. He said, okay. He bends over, rubs the tackle box. Needless to say, a very happy camper when the genie did come out. Said, I'll make it easy on you, Genie, $1 million. Now, this is a point in the story. A lot of people think a million deer came in out of the woods, but that's not this story. A million ducks landed on the lake we were fishing. He looks at me, he says, you're Genie. He's hard of hearing. Said, you know, that's a safe bet because I didn't ask for a 10-inch bick. You have to know a bick is a lighter. Anyway, if you got to explain them, they're not funny. I'll do you my favorite poem, too, if I got 2 minutes. I wrote this during the Occupy movement back in 2011, 2012. It kind of woke me up from a long sleep of raising stepkids and watching grandkids, and Occupy had an effect, but I started writing. I call it Downstream Water. 99-1, this new world order. The poor, we drink this downstream water. Being homeless is a lot like being in Vietnam, but not all the slaughter. Somewhere over there, I still got a daughter. There ain't no getting out of here, neither border. I just got a butter knife. They got mortar. After Namat, I was the hotel porter. Lost that job, all their fault, sorta. And I got into some shit I shouldn't have ordered. Hey, buddy, spare a bet a quarter? 99-1, it's New World Order. The poor, we drink this downstream water. It's hard to believe here in the U.S. of A, the great middle class is going away. Going broke in America is what they say. Middle class will be gone. No how, no way. Now, I know a lot of big companies have gone away or they're cutting back on their worker pay. I'd have thought our unions were here to stay. I ran into my brother, liquor store doorway. He wanted to talk this time, not just hey. Says he lost his summer house down on the bay. Man, I lay low there on them cold winter days. Says he's still got a little in his 401k, but he ain't got no health care. I said, that's okay. Neither one of us been sick in years anyway. His kids all moved home, student loans to pay. He picked up on a used Chevrolet, putting off that dream of a Beamer for some other day. Reached into his sack for a bottle, thinking he was going to make my day. I said, cigarettes, if that's okay. He went back in to get them, got some money out to pay, and picked himself up a couple more bottles of that cheap Chardonnay. 99-1, this new world order. The poor, we drink this downstream water. Now, most of you are going to be with me here down in the ditch by the time this dog-eat-dog starts getting the rich. Hey, they had the money deal. They had the pitch. The Wall Street merger, but there was a glitch. Balloon payment on the mansion, that damn hitch. Messy, messy divorce. She got it all, that witch. You bet the farm in Vegas had the itch. Bought into them kilos without a twitch and lost every dime to that snitch. You betcha for the rich, being broke is gonna be quite a switch. But hey, I'll move over. Here's your niche. Yes, ma'am, life's a bitch. 99-1 is New World Order. The poor, we'll share this downstream water. You thirsty? Boom.
I was just getting ready to compliment how you were able to rhyme so many words with itch without cussing. And then boom, there it was. So great alliteration though. Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Yes, stick around for the shoom shoom round where everyone is going to go again. Done. Perfect. With a really short piece. Everyone is going to perform again with a short piece.
With a short one. Okay, I'll be here till you're over. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. All right, up next we have Chanson. And I'm in the midst of reading his book right now. Can y'all see it? Really dope. Check it out. It's on Amazon. Nonetheless, he's up next.
Thank you, Rayanne. Let me see. I have 6 new haikus for you. Let me know if you need me to slow down to read them or whatever. All right. Number 1, Forever 7, Emotional Therapy, Poets Are Welcome. Number 2, Praise Logorrhea. You never run out of words. Please just keep talking. Number 3, Rayanne has hot bars. If she was a weightlifter, she'd be muscular. Number 4, working on third book. Poetry is my blessing. Hope you receive it. Number 5, creatives meet here. An AA meeting for words. I love poetry. Number 6, I friend you with this flower ring made of silver, so precious to me. Thank you.
Yes. Love me a good haiku.
You know how to make it topical.
Right? Huh?
I didn't hear what he said.
You know how to make it topical.
Oh, yeah, I try.
You succeed.
Thank you.
Okay, Lloyd is joining us. All right. Up next, we have General Lismo. Okay, I guess I will do a poem while we wait for General Lismo.
Hi, Lloyd.
Just kidding. Okay, Johnny on the spot. Feel like I'm walking on eggshells, inhale. Waiting to exhale, but God won't let me leave because I still got truths to tell. It was hard for me to look death in her eyes and to tell her that I loved her back to back to back. It was hard for me to look death in her eyes and to tell him that I loved them back to back to back. And Jesus was like, oh, well, I'm only here because I still got truths to tell. Pity accompanies my soul like pennies to a wishing well, and still Jesus be like, oh, well. Okay, that was the snippet of my poem coming out in July 27th, if things go as planned. If not, I will keep you guys posted. I'm launching a Tate Besh book, which I think is really cool, trying to bring some old school things back, right? Thank you. A Tate Besh book.
What does Tate Besh mean?
It means like do-si-dos, like backwards almost. So that means that when you open the book, you know, it's going to be just like how a book is supposed to be. But then when you flip it over, it's going to be another book as well. So it's two books. Yes, two books combined into one. And deja vu, wow. And they're gonna look really cool. It's gonna look really cool if all goes as planned. If not, it'll be a new day. I'll let you know. Okay, up next we have, let's see, Ayati. Are you here, darling?
Hi, I am.
Welcome back.
So I'm gonna perform another song today, and I'm gonna do a sound check. So you tell me if it sounds okay. Is that audible? So yeah, that was that.
I can.
Yeah, it was audible. Hear you.
Okay, I'm gonna begin. Tried to do like a little rendition over here, but I think I'm gonna leave that up to you. You did great. Thank you. Thank you for joining us again. Yeah. I appreciate the positive vibes. Okay. All right. So up next we have Word.
I'm going to do a rap called Sisters, or This Is For The Sisters. I'm going to start with the chorus and then I'm going to get into the first verse. I'm only going to do one verse though. This is for my sisters through all the tough times, like rhymes we fit together, the sublime that we be forever. I dedicate this one to the sisters for wisdom of the soul, the sublime if we make it through body and mind, always staying true to each other. there will be sister and brother. The mother of civilization, always stationed in my heart, smart and intelligent. The oppression is relevant, but we discuss it. You help me see when they don't see the light of just getting along. That's why you're so strong and necessary in the fight against racism and their supposed movement to hate. The notions that they are greater than us, like a power reality, like one you could trust. Tell you when they get you down, just know world will always be around. And profound at making it our world, dropping pearls of wisdom, all praise due. There's nothing we can't get through. It's me and you, sister, black and beautiful, and so mystical. You helped me to uncover the spiritual part of life, to help in life's strife, to live right like God expects us to. I love our communication, and I'll never leave you or make you blue. You're a constant reminder of what's right in the world. Calm, thoughtful, my girl, my pearl, my esteem, where it should be at. Your world, and I stated straight, no debate from the heart, more than the start. I hope we never part, but be with each other, brother to sister and sister to brother. Both from the mother continent, content is like the love we might make, mind, body, and soul. The whole spiritual experience is the goal of us together, and I've made up my mind, at least it's mystical. This is for the sisters. This is for my sister. Dun, dun, dun. All the tough times, like rhymes, we fit together, the sublime that will be forever. I dedicate one to the sisters for the wisdom of the soul. If we make it through body and mind, always staying true to each other, it will be my sister and brother. That's all I have.
Yes.
All right. Yeah. And hello, Atlas.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, word. That was dope.
Thank you, Lloyd.
That was dope. I was ready for the beat drop. Dun, dun, dun. I was like, okay. All right. Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun. This is for the sisters.
Hey. Dun, dun, dun. All right. Okay. So up next, we have Doran. Doran, awesome. Okay. So we are going to host a Pride panel this weekend. So come check us out. Doran is going to open up the show for us and do an amazing, lovely song titled Karma, I think. Yes, we're still going to Karma. Perfect. Okay. You have so many. I was checking out your SoundCloud.
Thank you.
Yes. So yeah, I'll drop the link or check us out on Eventbrite. I just realized that you guys can follow me on Eventbrite so you can stay up to date with any of our events and things like that. So follow us on there, follow us on the website. Okay, do you?
Okay. I'm just like, I was happy to be here right now and just like in this space. I think today I'm gonna just do like a jazz standard and keep it chill. So I'll get into it right now.
Before you start, I wanna know if you have anything that sounds like this. Dun, 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 dun.
No.
This is for the sisters. Dun,
dun, dun, dun. Hey. I'll get that ready for next week.
Okay. I'll be ready. I'll be ready to hand bob. Go ahead.
I fall in love too easily. I fall in love too fast. I fall in love. I fall in love. fall in love too easily. I fall in love too fast. I fall in love too terribly hard for love to ever last. My heart should be well schooled, 'cause I've been fooled in the past, but still I fall in love too easily. I fall in love too fast.
Wow, dude.
Yay. That was beautiful.
Chet Baker reincarnated.
Yeah.
Really, it was amazing.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Mm. Untamely beautiful.
Right. Thank you, Doran. You're just so amazing. Keep doing what you're doing. Like, you're just so great. Keep going, keep pushing, and keep putting music out there, because, I mean, we see you. So do you. All right. Up next, we have Lloyd. Lloyd.
Yay, Lloyd.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Glad to be here again. Can everybody hear me?
I hear you.
All right, you guys can hear me. Okay. I want to, I have a new poem that I wrote probably last week. So it's called Anywhere But Here. And it's basically an ode to my students. I have a lot of poems about my students, because that's my passion. So it's called Anywhere But Here. I know we have never officially met. You just read the police report that happened to have my first and last name. But you really don't know me. What you see is on paper, but that will never define me. I'm the opposite of a criminal. I just had a moment. Have you ever had one of those? I did. But no one knows the whole story except me. The courts, they only see me from a distance. Now you're seeing me up close. But I'm sure if you took the time to get to know me for who I am, that you would really see what I see when I look in the mirror every day. A kid that is lost in the system. I'm trying to find my way back home, but I need someone to help me get there. Can you help me? So, before you assume anything about me, can you at least hear me out? There are times when I'm supposed to be getting ready for school, and all I have to do is lock myself in the bathroom. I just don't want to face the harsh reality of what I'll face when I get there. I mean, my teachers don't seem to understand me. My peers, they treat me like I don't fit in. And my parents, they rarely take the time to pay attention to me. Unlike most of my peers, I actually grew up with two parents in my home. But the only place I can really call home is the streets. Trust me when I say, I've tried everything inside me to connect to all the right peers. But it seems like negativity seems to follow me everywhere I go. This may come as a surprise to you, but you've never seen me at my best. You just happen to catch a glimpse of me at my worst. I know you were inserted into my timeline to tell me all the reasons why I should not give up. And I appreciate that. I thank you for that. But sometimes I feel like I have nothing left to fight for. I'm literally crying out inside that I'm shedding tears. Kids like me, we shed silent tears that no one else ever hears. until they notice until something bad happens. I'll be the first to admit I've made some messed up choices in my life, but that doesn't mean that I'm a bad person. It just means that I should be held accountable, but I shouldn't be labeled. There are times when I hate the impulsive side of myself that makes decisions without considering the consequences. Yeah, I'll admit, I was that kid at the park that night when that fight broke out. But the report that you received, but that I know, because I know the whole story, I was actually defending myself. I mean, I don't have a violent bone in my body, but everybody has a button that no one should ever push. And between me and you, that night, my button was pushed. I've been bullied online, in school, and in my neighborhood by the same kid for the last 3 years. Did you know that? Was that part of my police report that you didn't see? And that night, I reached my breaking point. What would you do if you were that kid that reached their breaking point? I know what you're thinking. Why didn't I just tell an adult? Well, I did that. I told my parents, I told my school, and I even told my pastor. But no one took me seriously until I got serious about standing up for myself. That's sad, but it happened to me. So I took matters in my own hands. You would be amazed at how many kids just like me are running around in circles with nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, just thought to what their lives could be like if someone actually cared, if someone intervened on their behalf. I never planned to alter the course of anyone's life. I'm just trying to make sense of the life that I was given. Hopefully, the next time you see me, you will understand the kids like me, we just need someone to talk to, someone to listen to, someone that will provide a safe space where we can go anywhere but here. Because where I am right now, I don't wish that on anybody, my worst enemy. So please take me somewhere, anywhere from where I'm at right now, because I don't want to be here.
Wow.
One of your lines reminded me of something Marilyn Monroe said.
It's phenomenal.
If you can't take me at my worst, you don't deserve me at my best.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Thank you,
Lord. There's that one imponderable in that poem. Everybody has a button that shouldn't be pushed. And who of us knows what will happen when that button is pushed for us?
Yes. John.
Awesome. Thank you for joining us again, Lloyd. Hearing about your journey and what you do with the students, the children, is very encouraging. So keep telling me about it. Truly. Okay, up next we have Atlas.
Yeah, Atlas.
All right, Atlas.
First and foremost, it's really nice to see all of you. Familiar faces, new faces. I've been out of it for a while for reasons many of you may know. Here goes. There's a lot of people, so don't want to take up too much time. All right. Does anyone have an opinion I can borrow? I used to have one of my own, but individual opinions have become so expensive these days. Last I checked, they've been costing people their social media accounts, some of their friends, invitations to family members' dinners, and those are just the less expensive opinions. I just go online to check my email, and what do I see? Tons of articles about some people having opinions that cost them their job, their career, their freedom, their life. I can't afford to lose any of that, especially since I don't even have most of those things to lose. I've already wasted so much money as it is. I pay for this phone. I pay for this phone, but I can't call and talk to anyone and voice my opinion. I got this laptop, but I can't seem to use it for anything other than short, safe, work-related communication, because apparently no one close to me feels close to me. I went and got this fancy TV and all of the streaming services, but every show I try to watch ends up getting canceled or having all the characters fired and replaced, changed, whatever. Because, well, you know, opinions. I mean, sure, people are suffering from drug overdose, alcohol poisoning, and suicide from feeling as though they have no one to talk to and no safe space to be heard. But apparently, the more pressing matter is that some people are getting quite offended by what they read and what they hear. I mean, sure, every single person that has ever made a significant impact on the world we live in now started that journey because they were offended, but decided to do something positive about it. Every inspiring movie we've ever seen, every fascinating book you've ever read, every compelling speech we've ever heard, all of those are the lasting echo of someone who didn't like what they saw and made something better. But building something takes way more time than having something removed or destroyed. Starting something requires much greater investment than simply, I don't know, canceling something that exists. And borrowing someone else's opinion is much safer and cheaper than, I don't know, forming and expressing one of your own. I had my own thoughts, my own feelings, my own opinions, but I lost them somewhere along the way. While meandering through life, trying my best to gain the acceptance and approval of everyone I came across, I somehow lost track of what actually mattered to me. I somehow misplaced my identity. I was so busy stumbling, trying to keep up with everyone else, that I just dropped all the beliefs I was holding on to. So, can't really afford to be me or think like me. And here I am left asking once again, please, pretty please, does anyone have an opinion I can borrow?
Thank you. Woohoo! That was phenomenal.
Wow.
Thank you, Atlas.
Hey, Cynthia.
Atlas hits it out of the park again.
Thank you, Atlas. I remember you sent me that piece and I was like, I don't know. I don't know if I have an opinion that you can borrow. But yeah, thank you. Okay, up next we have Cynthia. Yes. No.
So yeah, yes, yes. Sorry, I was saying let me get something up. I was just making dinner. Here we go. I have a couple of short ones. These are not my novel, something totally different. Okay, this one is short. Poetry changes your vision. This is your mind, a crazy haywire mess of jumbled thoughts going everywhere, nowhere, getting some places, getting lost. Busy, busy, always freaking busy. How do you like living this crazy busy mind? Breathe, put your feet on the floor. Feel your energy reaching into the earth, down into the center and coming back to you. Breathe, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, and repeat. As I talk, breathe slowly. Inhaling to the count of 4, holding, exhaling to the count of 5, holding, and then inhaling again. Already your heart rate has slowed down. You may say, this is my mind on meditation, but I promise you, this is also your mind on poetry. Spend some time with poetry. Go to an open mic and listen. Go to YouTube and listen. Buy someone's book and curl up by the fire, or take it outside and curl up in the garden and put your feet barefoot on the earth so you are grounded. Do you have an issue going on in your life? Find someone's poems about it. Read them and process your stuff with them. You may be amazed. That's what another's perspective can add to your personal journey. History of rape, incest, abuse, trauma, poetry's got you covered. Dealing with relationships, divorce, love, poetry's got you covered. Dealing with weeds in your garden, too many dishes in the sink, poetry's got you covered. I do have more prescriptions up my sleeve. Sorry, I'm editing as I go along. I do. But that requires further conversations, and it's a starting place. Free to all who care to look. If you have something ailing you, look to poetry and then discuss your issue with that poem or those poems. Interrogate the poems and then write about it afterwards. Process those emotions, and you will find that quieter line, that mind that exists on poetry. Namaste. I wish you love and light. And then a very short one. Where'd it go? Keep a poem in your pocket. Keep a poem in your pocket, a draft, a scribble, a scrap. For when you find it on a gray morning, or perhaps on laundry day, it will surely bring a smile to your face. And that's all I got. Woo! Thank you. Now we'll buy a Zoom call. Go.
That's Cynthia. Hey.
Thank you, Cynthia. Thank you. Yeah, I have learned so much working with you, and you being the editor of my book. Like, thank you.
I've had fun working with you. Thank you.
I know, right? What a treat. Okay. Up next, we have Frank. Frank.
Good evening. Since I'm doing comedy, if people like to go off mute and show your faces, I can see the laughter. I put my comedy channel. I recognize most of you, and maybe some people who haven't seen me yet, who haven't been lucky enough yet to see me. So let's see. During the day, my job is IT, information technology software tester. And there are some people in IT that do cybersecurity work. There's actually a title called penetration tester. Not making it up. You can look it up online. In fact, I could not believe there's over 1,000 openings. Now, if I were to change to, you know, a new IT job, I would be very happy for horizontal movement.
Oh.
I would consider an entry-level position. I would even take an unpaid internship.
Yeah.
Now, we see all these job listings, and typical things that you see in a job listing might have a slightly different meaning for penetration tester. For example, salary based on experience. No dress code. All work is hands-on. pay for performance, potential for growth.
Wow.
And latecomers need not apply.
Oh my goodness.
Now, lately I've finally had a couple opportunities to do some in-person open mics. I mean, I'm not a bot with a large butt. I'm a real person. And I'm starting to get a little bit sick of this virtual stuff. I mean, everything is becoming virtual. Movies are being computer generated. What happened to the days where movies were shot on location? Like Mars or Venus. And they were meeting all these people on Zoom. I gotta ask, are they virtual friends or real idiots? And my doctor told me he wants to do a virtual colonoscopy. Heck, if there's something going on in my system, I wanna know what's really happening. If there's a problem, I'll call Roto-Rooter. Now, I know with this coronavirus vaccine, people are talking about the possible side effects. I actually heard a rumor that if the husband has the vaccine, the side effect is the wife loses her sex drive. Now, I wasn't sure if I should believe it or not. So just to be safe, yesterday I had my shot at 6 and I had sex at 2. Okay, I'm gonna make a confession.
Oh, Lord.
That joke. I thought it was very funny. And everyone can speak from experience. It's true. Now, we've all been asked to take special precautions because of the coronavirus. I think that maybe I have taken it a little bit too far. When I went outside, not only did I wear a mask, but I wore goggles, a spacesuit, and a condom.
Really? Oh wow.
And getting back to virtual reality, I went with this joke. I went with this. I actually love virtual condoms. Very simple reason. I can have a real orgasm.
Oh man.
Thank you very much.
That is hilarious.
You've been a great audience.
Yay, Frank.
Very nice. Very, very nice.
Awesome. So up next we have V. V.
Hey everybody. Okay, so usually I would sing, but I actually have been inspired of late. So I always preface this by saying I'm not a poet, but I've wrote a couple things. I usually have to have a muse. So I do have a muse, and they're quick pieces. So it's just, I actually just attended a workshop. So I just wrote this one tonight. So it would be better if you had the picture in front of you, then you could probably understand it more. Mm-hmm. I didn't title it, but here goes. It was just like a picture of different colors and dark colors and then bright colors. And so here goes. Out of the dark, I rise and climb to see beyond. Wait a minute. Out of the dark, I rise and climb to see beyond the, I tried to rewrite it. Out of the dark I rise and climb to see beyond the present of my mind. I reach out to a future I know I can call to me, create this destiny if I allow it to be. I break through to a bolder view, different hue, The colors so vivid, I get lost. I don't know where I'm going, but take me there. I don't care for the past. I can now paint me, my destiny, new colors. I'm free. So that's one of them. The other one, I'm sorry for being sappy. I had another poem and I thought it might be too spicy. John heard it before, so I don't know if it's appropriate for right now. But with Frank's comedy, it may be. But anyway, this other one I didn't title it to.
V, I can take it.
John, I'm not reading that one. So it's a little, but anyway. And he's not here, so the muse, so I can't embarrass myself, but anywho. So here's another one I wrote. I didn't title it, but it says, if I had one wish, it would be as, no, if I had one wish, if I had one wish, it would be as important as the first breath you take as you open your eyes to each new day. Or as important as the call you run to answer as your heart skips a beat, stumbling at your feet. If I could be as important as the first thing you think of or what you wish for at night, if I could be the sparkle or the twinkle in your eye when it's love at first sight. So that's another one. And this is the other one I wrote. It's called King. So here goes. You're my secret, but it's no secret how we align hearts and mind, thoughts in motion, deep as oceans, crushing against each wave, innocent but developing like a picture coming into frame. This bond has no name. It will be what it will be, you and me, organically, how it's supposed to be. That's it.
Wow. Whoever your muse is, I'm jealous. That's all I'm
saying. Beautiful.
You keep saying you're not a poet. Come on.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you, V. Up next, we have Kenneth.
Hello. Can you hear me? Okay.
I can hear you, but you got a lot of buzz going.
Oh, there is? Okay. Yep. I'll get to the song fast. We won't hear the buzz. All right. I have a song for you, and I apologize if you might have heard it before, but it's a Newsboy song. It's called Beautiful Song, Beautiful Sound. And I like to play it again because it's my favorite, so one of my favorites. And here we go, just without any further ado, just get right into the song. I'm going to be singing along with it, Phantom Voice style.
Turn the page, can't turn the light out. Every word, every line carries to my soul. Dark letters on a page singing so loud. Where did I go wrong up to here? 18 years, I guess it was alright. I let you do the thinking, I just bide my time. Father to son, son to hand me down. Where did I go wrong not to hear your song? It's a beautiful sound, moving through the crowd. Up for more.
On the song and then a little bit about myself, or the email, if you want to contact me.
Thank you for joining us again, Kenneth. Awesome. Okay, so up next we have Mimi. Long time no see. What's up?
Okay, you can hear me now. Okay. I was on mute.
I'm like, what's up? Okay, you're right. Oh.
Not great with technology. It's nice to see you too, Rayanne.
Yes. So what you got? What are you going to bless us with today?
Well, you guys, I have been newly diagnosed with bipolar depression. And so poetry has been my safe spot for some time now, but I've really been leaning on it these past couple of months. So I just have a little small poem, nothing too big, that I'll read tonight. I'm going to turn my camera off because now that I'm looking at it, it kind of looks like I have on the clothes. I swear I do. See? I've got on clothes. Board a flight into the night, shying away from pain, even if it's not right. I'm running away today. Stuck in a cage, too anxious to sing. I hear a song and spit a poem instead. It always sounds better than the pounding in my head. I'm running away today. Smooth as ice, cold as winter. Never knew another time I've been so bitter. I'm running away today. Toxic thoughts strung between vocal cords. My feet need something to carry me towards. I'm running away today. Bittersweet masterpiece, you always get the best of me. I can't hide, so instead I cry. All the time envisioning my train of the sky, where I can finally fly and maybe run away today. That's it.
That was hot. That was hot.
Thank you.
Venetia.
Lovely. Yes.
Do you know William Ernest Henley's poem Invictus?
I don't.
In the rapid round, I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Dope. Thank you so much for joining us. So freaking brave. I'm happy to see you. I'm happy that you're here. I'm happy you're alive. And thank you.
Thank you.
All right. So are you going to stick around and do another poem later? How are you feeling?
Me?
Uh-huh. Everybody.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
The whole crew. The whole crew. Shoom shoom round is coming up. Okay. All right. So up next we have Pete, and then we're going to do a shoom shoom round, 2 minutes for everyone. And that will be our Monday.
Hello. I'm so happy to be here. This is my first time. Thank you, everybody, for sharing such beautiful, beautiful, beautiful work. It's been tugging at my heartstrings this whole time. Thank you. Here's a little song I wrote, which actually started off as a poem at the beginning of the pandemic, called Wine Stains on the Ceiling. I think I'll take out my headphones. I don't want to hear my voice. Okay. Old buildings remind me of staying up till morning with you in all your glory while I smoke like it won't kill me. And your hands start exploring while we tell each other stories, and I don't want it to end. But it's all just a dream in my head. Wine stains on the ceiling aesthetically seduces, yet mildly produces a particular feeling of self-disgust and fear that you're destined to be feeling like you're descending into the deep end of a pool of secrets you kept below the surface, so you self-medicate on the weekends. But all that does is temper your emotions so you can try to adjust to making it through life on your own. But you're tired of feeling alone. So tired of feeling alone. So tired of feeling alone. So tired of feeling.
Well done.
Yes. Thank you for joining us. Okay, so now we're going to do the shoom shoom round. Doom, 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 doom. Okay, and we're gonna start at the beginning of the list, and 2 minutes for like each person, and we'll call it a night. So John is gonna open the show again for us.
All right, first, Ecclesiastes 3. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. So wrote Ecclesiastes. And now for Minutia Invictus. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll, I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul.
Thank you for reading that.
I loved it. Thank you, John.
You are welcome.
Awesome. Up next, we have David. David. Okay, I'm not sure if David is still with us.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm clicking.
Okay.
I'm here. Give me a second. Here we go.
Clicking.
I was always big on rhyme, and so I tried one without it. It's called Rhythm and Rhyme. My wife bet me $20 that I can't write and read a poem in free form verse. I said, what, one that doesn't rhyme? You're on. So I Googled, what, one that doesn't rhyme? I Googled it to save me a few minutes. Then minutes became hours, became a whole day looking for the right words to communicate and call it a poem. This Google thing is really cool. It's like having a city library in your house. Type the keyboard, click your enter button. Ain't nothing to it. Freeform verse poetry, first thing up on the screen. Free verse poetry has no particular rhyme. I got that. No particular rhythm either. Oh man, no rhythm? I mean, some sentences have to be ungodly long as to not establish any particular beat in the minds of the listening audience. Others are short. Now, I've been told that I've had rhythm all my life, but I do not know if I can even deliver a poem that is anything but rhythm and rhyme. So here, the opposite is civil dissonance. Okay, I'm big on civil disobedience. We all could use more of that. I can do this. I just did. My wife owes me $20.
Good for you. Did you get it?
Or it's in the same cookie jar. We'll leave it at that. Thanks for having me.
What an ending. Yes. Thank you for joining. Up next, we have Chanson.
All right, so since the first set, I wrote 12 haikus. Oh yeah, that's my first book that came out in August of 2019. From Crisis to Confidence is on Amazon for $9.95 and on ebook format for $3.99. So please purchase. Thank you, Rayanne, for your support. Okay, so I have 12 haikus.
You wrote 12 since the first set?
Oh my gosh.
Yes.
Amazing.
Okay, some of them are 575 and the other ones are 353. Number one, soft lips on lip gloss. Why is beauty so unfair? Come here, give me a kiss. Number two, gold-plated skin. She's been tried through the fire. Doesn't smell like smoke. Number three, voice sounds like music. Hope she comes a bit closer. I can hear angels. Number four, her smile makes my day. Her smile makes the sun jealous. Her smile is my joy. Number five, her soul has rhythm. All things her carries music. Baby, drop the beat. Number six, I love her so much. Her hair coils like a staircase. Lady Love herself. Number seven, looks like her sweet breath flows from her warm face to mine. Let me inhale you. Number eight, her smile, silver queen, appears when all things seem dark. You sparkle my life. Number nine, she's my muse. I confess my love. She ghosts me. Number 10, girls don't like feelings. If they come from the wrong one, return to sender. Number 11, my address has no visitor with the skirt. Number 12, take my breath away with your sincere, honest love. Feel at home with you. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you. When I was younger, I could sometimes do one. If I had a half an hour between the poet that gave me the inspiration and the time I could come up with at an open mic. But that many? Never. You are amazing.
Oh, thank you. Yeah,
and those are really nice too. I like those.
The muse is present, so
that helps.
So that helps.
Okay, so up next we have Ayati. Ayati.
Hi, Ryan. I'm gonna read a poem by this Irish poet and philosopher. His name is John O'Donohue. And the name of the poem is Banach, which is the Gaelic word for blessing. On the day when the weight deadens on your shoulders and you stumble, may the clay dance to balance you. And when your eyes freeze behind the gray window and the ghost of loss gets into you, may a flock of colors, indigo, red, green, and azure blue, come to awaken in you a meadow of delight. When the canvas sprays in the current of thought and the stain of ocean blackens beneath you, may there come across the waters a path of yellow light to bring you safely home. May the nourishment of the earth be yours. May the clarity of light be yours. May the fluency of the ocean be yours. May the protection of the ancestors be yours. And so may a slow wind work these words of love around, an invisible cloak to mind your life. That's it.
Awesome. Thank you. Up next, we have Lloyd. Lloyd. Oh, Lloyd is Okay. So up next, we have Atlas. Atlas.
Okay. Hold on.
All right. Show and tell. Let me see your ring. Too close.
That's not gonna, hold on.
Move it to the right. Oh, okay, there we go.
Ooh.
That wasn't the one I was referring to, but the one with the stone in it.
It's a dragon.
Oh.
Hold on. Does that help at all? Wait, I don't know what to do.
That's so cool.
It focuses on your fingernails, but not the not on the string.
Just come over 3918 Canal, apartment 2.
Atlas, we're not coming over, okay?
By the way, for the new people, I give my number and my address all the time. People are like, "Oh my God, aren't you afraid?" I'm just like,
"No,
of what?" Because like telemarketers call me anyway, so like it doesn't do any good. Because apparently people who I don't want to have my number anyway. So what does it matter? I don't know. Don't count this towards my time. This is discussion. All right.
Okay, up next we have Frank. No.
Hey, what happened to Atlas?
Oh, I don't know.
Come on, I want to hear from Atlas.
All right.
So yeah, go left mute if you're willing. So last year, Linda and I celebrated our...
Where are you going? Oh my goodness. The guy who tells jokes didn't pick up on one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Frank's like, I'm doing it.
Frank, they were just saying that to punish me for talking longer than they wanted.
Okay. So yeah, people can go.
By the way, I got jokes too. Have I ever told jokes in this room? Because I got a bunch of jokes. Frank knows. He's heard me.
Oh yeah. He's okay. He could do comedy for sure.
Yeah, so. I'm a funny. Here we go. All right. That's what I'm gonna do right now. I got some quick jokes in 2 minutes. Number one, my friend was gonna have a gender reveal party, but she decided to wait until the kid turns 18, just in case.
No.
No, you're my friend on that one.
I got, hold on. My friend wanted a dog. And after 5 months, she went ahead and adopted a dog because she couldn't have one naturally, and that's just what she do. Hold on. If you laugh, you take up my time. All right, next one. Ghosting has become so common that when people ask me, do you believe in ghosts? My response is, no, I'm sure she's just busy with work. I want to come up with a show called Ghost Hunters. We don't look for supernatural beings. We just go to local bars trying to find out why Stacy hasn't called John back in 4 days. My friends call me metrosexual, which is not true because I've never had sex on public transit.
Oh, jeez.
And last joke, you gave me 2 minutes. Last joke. I understand what they mean when they say that we're all in this together, right? Because at any point in time, if my neighbor were to lose her job, I would lose my internet. You know what I mean? We're all in this together. We're all connected, and as long as she stays working, I stay connected, is what I'm saying.
Amazing.
Ba-dum-bum.
All right, up next we have Frank with more jokes.
I put my YouTube comedy channel out there again.
Perfect.
I'm going to start off. This is not an original joke, but it's just so funny. I heard it almost 30 years ago. It's just so funny. I got to share it with you. There was this inexperienced guy went to a hotel and with a woman, and they agreed to a 69. Minute into 69, the woman farts. It was bad, but a minute later, they're back at it. Woman farted a second time. This time, the fart was so bad, the man gets dressed. He opens the door. He's about to leave. The woman says, "Where are you going?" And the guy says, "Oh, I couldn't stand 67 more of these."
1951.
That's how far back it goes. I heard in 92. I listened.
1951, Gene Tracy live at the Charlotte, South Carolina truck stop.
Okay, wow. Yeah, I didn't
Google
know
it.
And I heard it in 92.
That was older than you and me.
Yeah, it's so funny. So anyway, last August, Linda and I celebrated our 22-year anniversary. I thought I might get a standing ovulation. Now, I'm not sure if Linda feels about this, but I'll still carry around a photo of my ex. What do you think? Okay, here's the real girl. So when they say, "Frank, what did you see in Linda?" Well, it's obvious. She's attractive. She's sweet. She has a sense of humor. When they say, "Linda, what did you see in Frank?" She says, "I'm not sure, but I used to be very nearsighted." Now, before I met Linda, I've had hundreds of psychotic ex-girlfriends, and I got a nickname for all of them. Let's see, Derelict Dara, Crab O'Cheryl, Dawn and Out, Jill by Night, the Joan Ranger, the Connie Artist. And things actually worked out with one of them until it ended kind of abruptly. I gave her a ring, and she gave me the finger. And before I met Linda, I did terrible at pickup lines. I said to women, "I'm a famous chess player." Was really? Yes. I'm looking to meet a woman to make some moves on. Heck, at my age, I do far better at chess than I do at women. It's easy to get mated. And I'll end with this. You know, we had a Zoom meeting today at work. Everybody was asked, "What keeps you up at night?" First person says, "Computer failures." Second person goes, "Deadlines." I should say Zoom meetings. And they finally got to me, and I said, "Viagra." And I will end with that.
Good answer.
Thank you very much. And check me out on YouTube, like my videos, make great.
Yay, Frank. Make sure you guys support your friends, make a friend, create a friend. There's people on here, so follow them on social media, follow their platforms, Twitter. What other things are there right now? TikTok. I don't know, all of those little social media networks. And be sure to visit us online. Here's the time to plug. Do, 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 do. Yes, visit us online. We're getting ready to relaunch the website, hopefully in July. If, you know, long story short, yeah. I'm going to have some, I think, competitions for artists and just things for us to do while we're doing things, when we're doing them. So, yeah. Visit us online and stay tuned, stay up to date, because opportunities are coming. All right, Yes.
No, I was going to say, I thought we were wrapping. I was going to say, I'll share a quick haiku I wrote.
We still have a few more people to go, but we'd love to squeeze you in at the end, okay?
That'll work. It's a great ender. Nice to meet you, Frank.
Yeah, nice meeting everyone.
Yes, make a friend. I love to see it. Okay, up next, Cynthia, a friend I made. What open mic were we at? I don't know.
I don't remember.
one of them. And we met and it worked.
It worked so well. We've been tight ever since. Okay.
Yes, very good. Yeah, I'm very pleased. Okay, so I wrote this in the middle of last summer. What's his name? Lloyd, are you still on here? Okay, I don't know. It doesn't matter. Anyways, this is a poem from last summer titled Afterglow. It's the wee hours of the morning. I should be asleep, but I got up to pee. And I remembered with a hugely grateful, shit-eating grin, pardon my friend, of a new depth of friendship in an old relationship. I dropped the waterline yesterday with a former student. We both dropped the waterline, truth be told. I think he went first, shared our past, the ugly part. But then we talked about, he shared music, I shared poetry. We talked about gender and sexuality. Someone had dared me just a day earlier to write a poem about masturbation. So I shared that among others. He appreciated the work. And then this sweet 27-year-old boy, man, I'm sorry, this young man, he was so sweet, said he needed to take a cold shower. I told him not to bother, whack off, we're here on earth to enjoy or something like that. He was so happy, admitted a crush since being in middle school. Hell, if that's all it takes to motivate reading is a caring smile and a willingness to listen, I'm all for it. And I quote, but you for sure made me want to read. I am fucking giggling, tickled out of my gourd. I'm 60 years old, that was last year. And this sweet boy wants to fantasize about me. Hell yes, I give you permission. And I am laughing. He is shy, not shy, has anxiety about talking on the phone, so forces me to communicate through text, which I find very frustrating at times. I can text for a little while, but it's so much easier to talk, although now I have a record for when I lose my faculties. So the sweet boy wants to lust after this skinny old carcass. What a hoot. I love it. Thank you so much, young sir. You have so deftly stroked this old lady's ego such that she is in bliss laughing her arse off at 5 o'clock in the morning, appreciating that you exist on this planet. Told you had worth. The value you just added put years on my heart. I looked in the mirror when I last got up. I swear I look 5 years younger. I am so happy. Thank you. Afterglow. That's it.
What a fascinating story. I need to know more.
Awesome. I deleted I have to find, there was one that came the next day. It was called Poor Sweet Boy. And I wrote that the next day. And I deleted it about a week ago, but I know I've shared it with somebody on Zoom and I have to go back and find it, but there's a companion piece to it. Yes.
I think we were talking about this.
Okay. I'm stuff all over the computer, but yeah, I'm gonna find this one again. I will. It was worth it.
Okay. Up next we have B.
I almost want to read my spicy poem, but I'm not gonna do it. Okay. So I have this other thing I wrote. It's just silly. It's called She's Coming. It's no pun on that. She's coming. Okay. And it's a potty mouth in the beginning, so, you know. New shit, true shit, mess around and do shit. New lit, feeling the vibe. My tribe got me anxious for the future. New her, loving the way I feel. Keep it real, no time for games. Naming and claiming what I want, don't front. If you not with it, get out the way. New day for me to shine. What's mine is mine. I've aligned in my mind that it's my time. Ride or step aside. That's it.
Yay.
Short and to the point.
Basically.
Yeah, right. my kind of call to action poem. That was great.
Agreed.
Thank you.
Up next, yes, thank you for joining us, V. Up next, we have Kenneth.
Hello, okay, I'm gonna do a
part of the song because I can't fit it all in 2 minutes, but I'll try. It's Fireflies by Owl City. I'm just going to do the first part of the song, so here we go.
Right. With another musical selection, we have Pete.
Hello. My songs are a little long, so I'm actually just gonna read an old poem of mine. This is called Egyptian Love Letters. We paint our paws and paws hands high for the profitable offering to the night divine. Cleanse me dry and mark it but once. I'll give you your stars for the light that lacks in your testimonies on stones remembered. I trust the eye that has blessed the tips of these fingers with a vision of free flow. I will dance the dance undocumented and chant the call no capsule has captured. We are the stories of the evers and afters. We are the wick and the wit. We are but a whispering glint, such as the glow of our gleaming god Khonsu. We are the tellers and travelers of moons. So lay down, my love, your judgments of old, and walk with me timeless through mapless unknowns. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Amazing. Up next with more poetry, we have Mimi.
I'm sorry. Right. Here I am. okay, so I'll just
I'll read a quick one too. Melodious pools of acumen, haltingly gazing down the sides of splendor, yielding a fire that never dwelled, but stood stagnant, awaiting, always healing, it never failed. Inscrutable agony from tips, caresses from plumping lips, and before I ever knew, right before my slender vision, there, past bountiful pastures, stood you. The end.
Love is in the air. Everywhere I look around. All right. So that concludes our Monday open mic. We're going to have David close us out. Hopefully I will see you guys again. Be kind to yourselves and enjoy the rest of the week. Don't forget to visit us online.
We'll do it.
A haiku. A perfect evening. Conversation was so good, we left our clothes on.
That was good.
I loved it.
Perfect way to close out.
What can I say? But sorry, Cynthia.
Perfect way to close out. Thank you.
Yes.
You're welcome. Thank you.
What can I say? But ouch.
All right.
Thank you, Rayanne. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks for having me.
Bye.
Good night. Thank you. All right. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.